Chapter 4
From Peach Baskets to Hoop Shots Basketball Dr. James Naismith was a teacher at a YMCA training school. He taught physical fitness. In 1891, it was a cold winter in Springfield, Massachusetts. That created a problem. It was too cold to exercise outside. Naismith needed to find a fun activity that the men could play indoors. He hung peach baskets at both ends of a gymnasium. Then he picked up a soccer ball. He tried to shoot the ball into the baskets. The game of basketball was born. It quickly became popular. In 15 years, basketball was played around the world. In 1906, they changed from peach baskets to basketball hoops. By the 1940s, basketball in the USA had a professional men's league. It was called the National Basketball Association, or simply the NBA. Do you remember A.G. Spalding, the man who created the business of baseball? In 1894, he developed the first basketball. His company now makes the official NBA basketballs. It also makes the official NBA backboards. In fact, Spalding is the world's largest basketball equipment supplier. Perhaps you can say Mr. Spalding also created the business of basketball. Before 1954, the game was much slower than it is today. But a man named Daniel Biasone changed that. He introduced two new things. The team foul limit was one change. This meant a team was only allowed a certain number of team fouls. After the limit was reached, the other team got a free throw shot. Another change was the shot clock. Biasone wanted the pro game to have a 24-second shot clock. This meant that when a team had the ball, they had to shoot for a basket within 24 seconds. If they didn't, they had to give the ball to the other team. This made teams work harder to score faster. Biasone was inducted into the Basketball Hall of Fame for introducing the use of the 24-second shot clock. Before this, the average score in a game was around 80. After these two changes, the scores of basketball games started going higher than 100 points. But no one expected one person to score 100 points in one game. That's what happened in 1962. Wilt Chamberlain was one of basketball's superstars. In a famous game between the Warriors and the Knicks, Wilt scored 100 points all by himself. It is remembered as the 100-point game. This record has never been broken. At more than 2 meters tall, Wilt Chamberlain towered over other players. He had several nicknames. He was called the Big Dipper. It's because he was so tall he had to dip his head to get through doorways. Some called him Wilt the Stilt. Other fans called him Goliath. He played for the Harlem Globetrotters in 1958 and 1959. Then he started playing for the Philadelphia Warriors. He was the NBA Rookie of the Year in 1960. He was named an All-Star 13 times. He was the NBA scoring champion 7 times. He was the most valuable player, MVP, 5 times. Michael Jordan had a big impact on the sport. At first, people didn't think he could be a good basketball player. He wanted to play on his high school varsity basketball team. He didn't get picked. The coaches thought He was too short. So he played junior varsity. He practiced extra hours every day. He worked hard to improve his shot. When he grew taller, he joined the varsity team. In 1984, Jordan was passed over in the draft by the Portland Trail Blazers. He signed with the Chicago Bulls. He was the NBA Rookie of the Year. He set many more records. He won many more awards. In 1999, ESPN, a global sports broadcasting network, named him the greatest North American athlete of the century. He is in the Basketball Hall of Fame. Some people say the worst draft decision ever made was when Portland passed over Michael Jordan. Jordan signed a deal with Nike to market his own brand of athletic shoes. They are called Air Jordans. When he wore them on the basketball court, the NBA fined him. Nike paid the fine. This happened again and again. Finally, the NBA decided to allow players to wear Air Jordans. Many other products are now part of the Jordan brand. After he retired from basketball, Jordan became part owner of a basketball team. It was the Charlotte Bobcats. Now he is one of the richest men in the world. He was the first NBA player to become a billionaire. He achieved all of this because he didn't give up. When the high school coaches didn't pick him, he worked harder to reach his dream. He is quoted as saying, "Obstacles don't have to stop you. If you run into a wall, don't turn around and give up. Figure out how to climb it, go through it, or work around it." The Harlem Globetrotters is a basketball team that doesn't believe in obstacles. The players entertain crowds with fancy tricks. They have some funny nicknames. Jaunty Too Tall Hall is the shortest Globetrotter ever. Paul Tiny Sturgis is the tallest player ever. Another player was named Super Mario Green. Corey Thunder Law once made a hoop shot blindfolded. He did this from over 21 meters away. He could also shoot backwards without looking at the hoop. His longest backward shot was 25 meters. In 2013, he shot a hoop from 33.45 meters away. Crowds love to see the tricks the players can do with the basketball. Today's hoop shots have come a long way from the peach baskets in Springfield, Massachusetts.